Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Connor, here with my father,
Kevin.
And I say the intro the same every time. I got made fun of, but I was on a podcast.
I saw that, yes.
They did the intro, and I didn't realize that I say it the same every video.
Well, I give you kudos for being consistent. It's something that's great, right?
Yeah, but I don't know if I should change it one day. Should I say something different?
Try it now. Hello, everyone!
No, this doesn't come out. I'm trying to say
hello, everybody.
I can't. Welcome back, ladies. See, that just goes. My brain is like a short circuit and it just doesn't work. Welcome back, everybody. We're going back today, going way back in the past. I was a child when I heard this project. Small infant, no. Mac Miller, you're kind of a fan.
I am a fan
at this point.
I am a fan. I can't wait to hear this project.
Yeah, I'd say you're a little more than a fan.
Yeah,
you have merch. You have his album looking down at you while you're working.
Yeah, he keeps me company.
So you're a pretty big fan of his work. Yeah. So we're going back to the start, and this is where. Not everybody was introduced to Mac, but you know, a good amount of people. He was making music before this, but this is kind of like his breakout mixtape.
Okay.
And I remember the first time I heard this, my friend, you're probably not watching because I know you're a busy man, but Arnold, if you are watching this,
hey Arnold.
he actually showed me this project. We were on a school trip back in, this was in elementary school. Because the elementary schools in Canada here go up to what grade?
Seven.
It's not like the states with the middle schools.
So you guys were kids.
Yeah, we were kids, and we were in Montreal, of all places in Canada.
Oh,
and
wow!
He was one of the few people in our class that had a actual like phone that wasn't. Like had access to the internet.
You and said could, he was always he had the like the best, right?
Yeah, he was like in always a step ahead in terms of phones. So he had like a nice phone. It had a screen. Like all of us had other phones that you know they like the screen was maybe like that big.
Yeah.
His was like a legit screen, and he let me listen to the project on his phone when we were on the on the bus driving to the airport or from the airport. Don't remember the details, but
yeah.
I heard it for the first time, and I remember him listening to it. And his big thing was like, dude, you got to hear this. He's like you. I'm like, what do you mean? Like, he's like, he's like, he's white.
And I was like, oh my God.
And I was like, okay. I mean, yeah. So I listened to it and I was like, oh fuck, this is a good project. It's really fun. But I just thought that was funny because, I don't know, at that point, there wasn't that many white rappers that my friends were listening to.
Yeah.
They were just getting into rap and they would show me songs and albums and whatnot. Like Kid Cudi was and Kanye and Drake and stuff was big around then.
This 2010?
Yeah, around 2010.
So yeah.
My relationship with Mac Miller
goes way back
and it grew over the years. And it's kind of cool that I've been able to introduce him to you.
You just took it out of my head. I was just going to say it's so cool that you introduced to an old guy like me.
And we're going backwards.
It's really neat, man.
Yeah. So there's stuff between this record. It's not like this is, you know, we're at the end now. We've got lots of Mac projects we haven't covered. But I figured this one would be fun to go back to. And we've done a couple mixtapes in a row. Days Before Rodeo. Then we did Nostalgia Ultra. That Patreon exclusive just because of copyright issues. But figured why not do a mixtape trilogy in a way. Track number one, kicking incredibly dope shit intro.
When you're young, not much matters. When you find something that you care about, then that's all you got.
Music
is what I love. Take that away from me, and I really got nothing.
Ha-ha. Make sure I'm coming through clear here.
The voice sounds so young. So young.
Motherfucker, I feel like the hardest working kid in America playing with the pros. I remember being amateurs.
And you can I can really hear the youth, eh?
Yeah, for sure.
For sure, yeah.
But not thinking about a college. Love with these rhymes, want to
favorite time. Man of the year, got my image stuck in your mind. I'ma bring a couple homies, you could call a couple friends. Is there a type of alcohol that you would recommend? Being young, so fun now.
This must have been great for you at in grade 7? I'm channeling you in grade 7. Now dealing with some motherfucking
kids. Well, I think anybody that was his age, too, listening to this. Like 17-year-old guy listening to this.
Oh, yeah, that's,
kicking some incredibly dope shit.
So yeah, that's a little sweet intro.
You know what? The way I was taking this in was that I'm not looking at swimming. I'm not looking at anything that he's done. I'm in my head.
Picture yourself in 2010 when this is coming out,
and I'm thinking of him at 17, and he's sitting there showing me because you know there's that thing. Right, and he's like, "Come in the studio. Come here for a second, Kevin. Come here.
See what I made."
Yeah. And that's the impressive part, right? Mm-hmm. You can really hear the youth in his voice and in the bars, but I found where you can hear the most amateur is that not so much his spit in his bars and stuff like that, but more in the pad.
Yeah, yeah. What you'll notice is there's a couple songs on here. I'm not too crazy on the first couple tracks, but it starts to pick up and feel a little more like less amateur as the mixtape goes on.
I don't mean that in a bad way. I think it's so cool to know where Mac I've heard
started. Yeah,
yeah. So it's you going in reverse again is cool because it's like the foundation. It's like when somebody starts to fucking do MMA or ride a bike for the first time, right?
Yeah,
like
small little glimpses potential, and it's really sweet. Yeah, no, I like that intro track. Like I like this mixtape because I played the shit out of it when I was younger.
It must have been that I was smiling inside thinking of that because I remember when you went on that trip, I was fucking sick to my stomach.
You were? Why?
I was
because I was away.
It was the first time you're going away and you're going across Canada on an airplane. I remember being at the window like this and I waited till your plane took off and I'm fucking, I don't know why I put on the fucking song. I put on Joni Mitchell, right?
I thought you put on this one.
No, I put on Joni.
That would be fucking crazy.
That would be weird. No, I put on Joni Mitchell, right?
Yeah.
And I'm leaving on a jet plane and I'm like looking and fucking you go up and I'm like, listen to that. I'm like, oh fuck, my little boy's gone. And then you come back and you fucking you're listening to it. You guys all came off the plane, I think, 3 years older.
Yeah,
it seemed like.
But yeah, listening to that, I listened to this whole project on the bus. Thank you, Arnold.
I was gonna say kudos to Arnold. That's awesome
for letting me hear it.
Yeah.
Track 2, Outside.
Hey, is that from?
That's probably from GarageBand.
GarageBand. Yeah. I think I've used that one.
Do you mind if we smoke this blunt outside? Cause it's nice out and we could get high. I wake up, don't want some clothes and out the door. I won't be back. My shining sun horizon setting up a lovely backdrop. Breath of fresh air is something right. I don't wanna be inside today. Just keep it rolling like we riding skates. Yeah.
I like a little laugh.
I'll be on some hippie shit, but get way fresher than the hippies is.
I like that the lyrics aren't heavy.
No,
he's
a kid, you know.
I know. Come on. Nice.
I'll be on some kid shit. Gonna take my shorty on a picnic. And every day feeling like it's Christmas. Rain, go away. Waiting for my homie Mr. Sun to come our way. Little kids running through the streets playing.
Yeah.
Poppy on the porch, you ain't got time to waste it.
You must have, I go to keep saying to you, like I was hearing this, but when you heard this chorus?
Yeah. Oh, we used to ride our bikes and listen to this, and skateboard and stuff, and it was fun.
He just notched up another level coming to Outside.
You think so? Like with the chorus and stuff?
Yeah, from K.I.D.S.
Yeah, yeah.
The opening track, intro. Yeah. Yeah, that's it. Still using those strings.
Yeah, a lot of the tracks on here are just really fun.
That's what I like. I love that. That's what you should be doing at 17, right?
Yeah.
Like, that's having fun. Like, it's like, let's go outside. I'm not saying smoke the dope. That's, you know what I mean?
But I don't know if he was 17 or 18 or I forget how old he was exactly, but around that age.
You know what? Well, his chorus is fucking great. You can hear you can hear him already starting to have these.
You can tell he's a good musician. Like, yeah, he's got that ear for.
And you can hear a bit of the jazzy vocals that he did later on, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Right, that was fun. That was just fucking. I'm happy to listen to Mac. It's weird,
yeah.
You know, because it's the albums we've done so far are dark, right?
Very dark,
and. Even the Divine was, you know what I mean? It had its darker moments. It had its darker moments in it. It was talking about love and sex, and it had a lot of horniness, right?
Yeah.
But this is just like, let's go smoke some weed outside. Let's...
Yeah. Well, this is before, you know, anything. I think he, what's the song at the end of, what's it called? Swimming, 2009. I think in that song, he's kind of referencing like these times, you know?
Yeah.
Where it was just kind of. Everything was chill. It was before any shit hit the fan. He wasn't, having too many, you know, struggles in terms of like addiction or anything like that.
Yeah.
So I think that's kind of what he's referencing back to on that swimming song is these times here. You know, it ain't 2009 no more.
Well, you know, and I told you the story, and I'll just tell the viewers here is that your friend, our friend, editor Ayrton, left a BMX here, right? And I've been borrowing it and going around the block and shit like that. And my buddy Brian jumped on it the other day. I to see a guy in his 50s, he went out there and he goes, "Whose bike is this?" And I go, "Oh, it's Ayrton's. I'm just using it." And he sat on it. It went from fucking here to here.
His face.
He was like, once you sit on a BMX
he and felt that youthful.
It was youthful. He was just, I saw him smiling. I'm like, go onto Craigslist, get a bike for $200.
And you guys can bike around.
And what did I say? I said, we can go, because we loved, this is our thing, man. We'd go to 7-Eleven and get the red hot burritos.
Yeah.
Right? The red hot burritos, really hot with their hot sauce.
A big gulp.
And then the extra big gulp. That was fucking magic, man. You're 17 years old. Like,
yeah, that was like the dream.
The best thing, man. When I rip around the block at night, and I'm just flying and I'm jumping a curb and shit like that, I'm still that age.
Yeah,
I'm still 17. But people looking out the window
are probably like, "What the fuck is this guy doing?"
This fucking gray-haired guy flying around the block.
Fucking listening to Travis Scott on a Bluetooth.
Yeah. What's wrong with them? Most people go with a fucking, you know, guys go and they get a, you know, the old
really
days,
expensive car.
Or something like that. Yeah. Riding around a BMX listening to Travis Scott. There's something fucking wrong.
Track 3, Get 'Em Up.
Turn the volume real high. If you try to build a vibe, throw your hands up in the sky. You didn't fuck with the volume?
No, it's just how it was.
Yeah, it's just, it's up. Get them up. We'll stay spinning on the Civic, boy, I'm always on the move. When you grinding all the time, there's a lot of shit to do. Clean shoes, boy, new feet. And I'm never in the car with only two seats. Who the fuck you think you playing with? I'm Justin Bieber, meets Jada Kiss. Here to take what's theirs, treat them all like Taylor. This me, motherfucker, I ain't changing shit.
He's got a little bit of like Lil Wayne influence on his wordplay, you know?
Yeah.
With those puns and stuff.
I can't get over this. Like the really fuzzy synthesizer.
Yeah.
Great chorus, too. Got a brand new phone, rocking brand new clothes, leaving every single party with a brand new hoe. Get him up. I was just going to ask you.
Yes.
Sorry, go ahead. No. Do you feel that, like, you know, we've talked about artists being influenced by their certain other people, right, that they admire. Do you think for him on that those bars it was Wayne?
Oh, for sure. Yeah. Definitely some little Wayne influence on the puns.
I like the start of the chorus.
The chorus is fun. The bars are fun. Like they're funny and then they're good. Yeah. It's like it's a good track. It just didn't for me it didn't stick with me as I grew older. Whereas some of these tracks that are coming up, specifically the next one actually. I still play to this day.
Wow. Okay.
It holds a special place in my heart, I think, because one, it just, when I heard it as a kid, it really was something that I just fell in love with it. I resonated with it. But it's also a good song. So it's like still stands the test of time.
Yeah.
You know, it's not just the nostalgia that's holding me to it. It's also a pretty good song.
Yeah.
It has a really good Nas sample. Saw Filmatic where he says, "Nikes on my feet make my cipher complete" or something like that. So Mac or Germ, whoever the producer that worked with Mac on this, sampled that. And the track's called Nikes on My Feet. I got to show you these shoes that my friend Bernie, he was, you know, big into the sneaker culture as well. Like this was blog era. So we were all on Tumblr. We were buying shoes, you know, at the mall and listening to stuff off Datpiff. Like that was the, that was what we were doing like every day in the summer and even in school and stuff. Bernie was into, he got us all into Supras. You know, the Supra shoe.
Yeah,
skater shoes. Yeah. I think at the time Justin Bieber had a big collection of them.
Yeah.
But he bought these. He got his mom to buy them for his birthday. I'll find them right here. They're the ugliest shoes. They were like super high tops. You know high top shoes, right? These were like quadruple high tops.
They're
so ugly. God, I don't know if you guys can see that. This here, that's more shoe. Anyway,
yeah, you can.
They were fucking huge. They went up to like about here. Track number four, Nikes on My Feet. In the Nikes on my feet, keep my sight complete
like. That's it there, right? In the Nikes on my feet, keep my sight complete. Hey, lace them up, lace them. Blue suede shoes stay crispy like bacon. Nikes on my feet make my sight complete. Young boss, bitch, paper in my pockets. I got a closet filled with shoe boxes. Mom said my spending habit a little bit obnoxious. Finna blow, don't snooze, don't sleep. All I really need is some shoes on my feet. That's a cool thing, eh?
Yeah, I know. It's all about just fucking having a fresh pair of kicks. That's why we loved it so much.
Yeah.
Look, my money good, but these hoes bad, so they stay attached to my gonads. Waking up to a few L's. Open up my closet to that new shoe smell.
Oh, I get that glass.
I guess I'm doing well. Say what up if you see me around. Nike ass, separate my feet from the ground. It's just Nike's on my feet, keep my
sight complete. Really simple organ production, eh?
Yeah, very chill. Listen, old school.
Yeah.
That was one of my favorites off the record. Just it was a fun one to listen to. You know what? Yeah,
you can't not be happy. Like it's just simple, those simple things in life.
Yeah,
like right.
Getting a fresh pair of shoes.
I want to go to the mall now
and buy a pair of Nikes.
Yeah, just a fresh pair.
Track number five, Senior Skip Day.
Kids. I'm just high, what they hating on me. People tend to think all the drinks on me. I be on my grind, rain, sleet, snow. Rolling up good every place we go. Cause we try and get high,
get high,
get high, get high,
get high.
Get high. Oh, they getting stoned. Rub my eyes and
nice.
Check my phone.
Nice bass, yeah.
The fridge to make some waffles. But no more sip left in my body.
Hey, I've been there.
It's okay, hey, gotta work what you got. Hey, gotta work what you got. Supposed to be in class, but I ain't going.
Little egg. Is that horns?
Yeah.
Oh wow. I could totally see you. you and your friends and fucking.
Yeah.
You know.
Escape the stress, but I don't give a fuck if the house a mess. Get cream cheese in a bagel. Have a glass of milk in an egg. I'm rocking PJs and no shirt. I smoke weed yogurt. Enjoy the best things in your life, cause you ain't gonna get to live it twice.
Look at fucking Mac. He's even teaching back then.
Yeah.
I really like this track. This is fucking
smoke some weed, eat yogurt.
Yeah. Fuck, he had some great bass going way before Thundercat came in.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that was a skit, I forgot.
Hell yeah.
All I could think of was you through this whole song.
It's such a fun song.
You know when you've been there more recently than I, but you know when you have a song, and I've told you the story before of like me playing songs on my BMX and feeling fucking cool because the song made me cool.
Yeah, it made you feel cool.
That I could see that making you.
Yeah, that was, we would listen to that all the time.
Yeah, like, you're totally bumping that, feeling fucking cool.
Yeah. Right? And but, like you said, Mac's kind of preaching back then even.
That was still fucking great, man. Like 17 years old, right?
Yeah, 18, 17.
Yeah, enjoy the best things in your life because you ain't gonna get it.
Ain't gonna live it twice.
get, yeah, because he ain't gonna get to live it twice. Yeah,
yeah. That's what... So he's been saying the same thing this whole time. It's just as he got older, he was just became more poetic with it.
Yes,
here it's pretty straightforward and blunt, you know. But as he got older, he just kind of, you know, made it. He became more of a better writer and stuff.
Yeah.
But he's always had this, you know, introspective and positive side to him. And,
at 17.
Yeah.
Like, it's crazy.
Well,
man.
And I remember listening to this record, and I had that feeling of, like, you know, that I still get listening to Swimming and stuff, where it's like you feel like you've got a buddy.
Except
this is just the more, this is just the fun buddy. This is where you're like, you're young and you're just having fun. Swimming, you're sitting, he's more of like a therapist. You're sitting down and you're chatting. He's like, or like a buddy that you go to as, like, you don't have a therapist, but you go to your buddy because he's the best thing.
Yeah.
Closest thing to a therapist.
Oh, totally, totally.
Track 6, The Spins.
Wow.
Dope shit like that, Jerm. Oh, hi. Welcome back to K.I.D.S. Wanna get a mansion, a jacuzzi, a theater to watch my movies. Mirror, mirror hanging on the wall. Who the flyest white boy of them all? Got your girlfriend screening.
Yeah.
We fucking and you cuddling. Like, baby, where the fuck you been?
This is fucking huge.
Yeah, it's a sample.
Holy fuck.
Pick, yeah.
Fuck, that sounds great.
Yeah.
Oh my god, you know, fuck. This to me sounds like something, just the structure sounds like something from Gorillaz.
Oh, a little bit, yeah.
Right?
For sure. With the rap versus.
With the rap and then this big chorus.
Yeah.
What a cool choice of the, what?
Yeah.
The sample.
Oh yeah, I just graduated high school.
That was fucking great.
Yeah, fun track.
That was really, really cool. What's the what's the original
sample
from? Yes.
I'm not sure, actually.
I gotta read here, because that was fucking great. Mac takes the beaten chorus from Empire of the Sun's Half Mast in order to make a dope-ass song. Well, the lyrical content isn't all that amazing. The real purpose for the song was to showcase his flow. How easily he can speed up, break it up. Wow, that's fucking great. Spins is a term used to describe the spinning sensation felt by some people intoxicated by weed and alcohol.
Yeah, alcohol. You mix them together.
I've done that.
I don't like the spins. Track 7, Don't Mind If I Do.
Oh, I like that. Very video game.
Yeah. Well, have you heard this original sample? I got a filled up phone, but I'm busy, so I'm ignoring her. Yeah, I just touched down in California. No disrespect, though. I got addictive cigarette flow for the green pesto, presto.
This is what I was talking about when I said K.I.D.S was gonna be some life changing shit. Bitches.
Most dope. Oh, I love the sloppies.
Yeah. Making me sound crispy and shit.
So educated and getting paid quick. If you ever hated, anticipate that I'm famous. Life good, never wanna end this. Me and Mary Jane got a really nice friendship. Feel like the K.I.D. working at the mill now. You suggest chilling, smoke joints up at Bill's house. Now I got a schedule, things I gotta do. Doing interviews, see it up on YouTube.
I really like this fucking drug. Like a dream,
about to wake up from a nap. How fucked up was that life?
Yeah, I recognize that voice.
Yeah, it's from a pop. Like, it's from a pop song back then.
Fuck, this one goes hard. I love
it. Yeah, it's one of my favorites.
Wow.
I love the sample.
You know what? I fucking love how fast he got there for a while.
Yeah, he really sped up his flow. He's kind of showing off what he can do.
Picked it up. That was a fucking great track. Do you mind if I look at this? Because it's driving me nuts.
Look at what?
See if it talks about who the woman, the female singer is.
Oh, it's a male singer.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it's just pitched up. It's Owl City.
Oh, Fireflies. That's what it was. Okay, that was fucking great.
Yeah, it's a fun one. That's another one that we used to listen to a lot. Track number 8, Paper Route.
Shit's Chevy, please let me roll this weed up. This the main event, so watch the people pull they seats up. Never on no cheap stuff. Here we got expensive takes. Green lights, never press the brakes.
Yeah, you did Mac perform these later on, I you think?
Not all of them.
Not, no. No. A few, maybe? Some?
Maybe, yeah.
You can watch me do my thing.
If we do anything to get this paper, so they follow everywhere we go.
Gin cup sipping, that's me, that's what I do. I got the gang in my bloodstream, strong how I'm living. And I'm G'd up, so now they just throwing no way to kitten. It's real. I
love the backing tracks in this.
Yeah.
Told me about you. I just sit back. Light mans and middle finger, you suckers with my nice rams.
Oh my God.
So whether home on a road.
Yes, this progressively got better production wise.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Wow, it really.
So for the bullshit we ain't got later, cause we out here on this road.
That was fucking great.
Yeah, no, it's cool.
Another great track, man.
And I like how it does feel very mixtapey, you know, in the sense that the tracks kind of just flow together.
Yeah.
And you've got, like, one thing I like about, you know, mixtapes, at least in this era here, is, like, the artist usually will talk between verses. Not talk, like, have a full speech, but they'll say some shit, you know, they'll reference the tape, they'll be like,
yeah,
you know, whereas you don't have that much in you know, an album. Like on Swimming, you don't hear Mac saying like, yeah, it's Swimming, bitch.
Yeah. Like, or Nostalgia's fucking tape going, right?
Yeah.
All that kind of stuff, yeah.
You know, so it's like, those things are always fun for me because they keep it very consistent. And so it's like, even though, you know, mixtapes are, you know, showing off different styles, so it can feel a little all over the place.
Yeah,
but I think having the artist almost be like a narrator through it keeps it kind of together. Track 9, Good Evening.
When I party in New York, take the late night subway, going out Friday, then coming home Monday. Super califragilistic. Incredibly dope shit. Make my mama proud, cause my clothes fit. Mac Miller. Taking sips from the fountain of youth. If you ain't heard about the kid, then you out of the loop. I be on some shit that they ain't never done before. Taking over piece by piece. Starting from the core, it's only been a year. I can stick around 100 more.
Fuck, that was great.
Yeah,
really good, right?
Jerm, you might as well keep this one rolling.
See, like this kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Doesn't happen in an album too much.
Yeah, it really sounds like they're doing it off the fly.
Yeah.
Live fast when I die, better wish me well. I just hope they serve and bear in hell. Just an everyday story that I'm here to tell. Boy, I'm a beast, match the style and bars. Find me smoking weed where the wild things are.
Cool.
Yes, sir. So I mean, I take this time.
Cool. Yes, sir. I love that fucking vocal sample.
Yeah.
You know, I just wanted to say that was cool, but I know what's different for me, and I got to put this into a sexual.
Great.
What?
No, it's great that you have to do that.
No, because I this is just something that has to be said.
Yes.
You know how I said later on, Swimming and Circles and stuff like that, Mac is slow. He gives pauses for you to have a conversation, and that's that thing.
Yeah.
Mac here is spitting at such a quick speed, you don't have time to get in a conversation.
Yeah, he's... So if you're going to go sexual, like...
He is... There is no foreplay. It's... Boom, da na 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 na
na. Like a typical 17 or 18 year old, you know, just fucking
yes, right.
But you know, as he, when he got older, he's 26, you know, he's taking his time,
pouring a glass of wine. God,
yeah. Fire, light some candles,
you know,
put on some jazz,
yeah, set the mood, you know what I mean, maybe run a bath, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah,
so that's I'm just making that point because that I was listening to, it was very fast, and I felt, and I'm listening to the bars, and he's spitting really great, and the music's going that sample.
Yeah.
But it was like, he was like, oh,
yeah. I get what you mean.
I gotta say, man, very wise young guy. Mm-hmm. Very, very wise in his writing and in his lyrics. He's just very wise. And you know, speaking of like booze and me slowing down shit, Mac taught me that Listening to Mac made me really, and I mean this all in my heart, slow the fuck down.
Yeah.
And you can, you know that I've slowed down. You've seen me.
Yeah.
I've slowed down, and I thank him for that because, you know, you've seen the video of Mac and he's out in the garden.
Yeah.
That one's famous one.
Yeah.
People have sent it to him.
Share it all the time.
And it's like, man, I look at that every time and I see it and I just go, fuck, I got to just go out and smoke some weed outside and say hi to the neighbors. And it's, you know, and he did this at such a young age. It's amazing. And you can hear these little snippets of him here at 17.
Already with that mindset.
Yes. I was just fucking Hustler magazine. I wasn't writing songs with any meaning and going, you know what? You only got one shot in life. You should do as much. You can get rid of all of
it. No, keep it all there for sure. Track 10. Ride around.
Riding with the window down, rolling through the city. Got the weed going round when the most dope with me.
Wow, different vocal change.
Yeah.
Simply getting high, New York, Atlanta too. Flyer than Santa shoes. She bring her camera through. I'm playing Crash Bandicoot. This beat a bitch. Got
I get all this stuff.
Server. I'ma rape the game. No Roethlisberger. Hey, what they
I love that he throws in all this Philly stuff, eh?
Yeah.
When he was talking about the six rings, he's talking about, I thought he was talking about the
hockey.
Like
no,
hockey,
no.
Yeah. Okay, you know I'm gonna be fucking
Well, it's such a vibe thing. Like it's full tank of gas, nothing to do, drive around.
Yeah.
Nike watch, pal chain, spend a day like me. Every dream vivid, talking how I live it. Up in the airplane, Quidditch, bitches. We just trying to ride around.
Yeah, and he wears Pittsburgh on his sleeve, you know, it's
very dedicated.
Yeah. I mean, his first album is named after a park in Pittsburgh. Yeah,
you told me that's where everybody congregates,
every
right?
year they have like a memorial for him, they'll sing and stuff.
Oh, wow.
And smoke and put lighters up. That one's a nice, fun one to actually ride around to. It's just, you know, the whole mixtape is fun to really just go out and do stuff, you know? Like, just, you just want it in the background while you're hanging out with buddies. And
It's fun. It's just, it's fun. And then there's no serious heavy-duty topics in it. And that you shouldn't be doing that at 17, you know what I mean? People have to because life circumstances and shit like that have to deal with stuff. But 17 would be, it's just nice just to fucking skateboard.
And just have fun.
Have fun.
And try to enjoy that time.
Totally, man. I reminisce about that so much and just think about the simple times. Like it was just, you know what I mean? I love when you, like looking back, because you're the closest, you know what I mean? Me looking at you is how I get the fastest look back to youth. You know what I mean?
Yes. Yeah,
Without me having to look back at myself. But you guys, when you had $4 eating cheeseburgers and just going out of your way, we talked about this the other day, going all the way across the city.
Because there was a deal on 2-for-1 burritos.
Two for one burritos. Yeah. And then I just loved that time, you know?
Yeah.
You guys would go to Safeway and just be like, what? We're going to get Safeway chicken. Like, it was such a big deal.
That was the fucking whole day.
Like,
what are you doing this Saturday? Oh, we're going to go to Safeway and get a chicken.
I know.
That was it. That was the plan. We're going to go get a rotisserie chicken, eat it in the park, and that, I don't know. That's it. That was the day.
But that was fucking great.
It was awesome.
Right?
It was a great time. Track 11, Knock Knock.
I've heard this.
You've heard the sample.
Everybody, please put a thumb in the air. Hey.
He keeps bringing up his Civic.
I love the knocking.
Pretty. If you got weed, you can come fly with me. Don't forget it when I'm wrecking the etiquette for the hell of it. Smelling it when the L is lit, I'm flying in a pelican.
That was great,
so damn intelligent. Fuck a job, I'ma get these dead presidents.
Nice.
And I think there is a bridge on this song, if I remember correctly.
Who?
A bridge.
Oh,
I think.
This one's really catchy. Great fucking beat, eh?
Yeah, I love the drum program. Or I guess they programmed it or played it live. I don't know what they did, but.
Ah, that was fucking great. Yeah. Knock, knock. Where can I? that was fantastic.
Love that track.
What a catchy song.
It's the chorus is infectious, and then he's got some really great like times where he speeds up his flow.
Yeah, yeah, and he's showing off there a bit.
Yeah, and it works out well. It's not like it doesn't feel forced.
Yeah, but a bridge. You know what? When you said bridge coming up, and I'm like, wow, fucking bridge.
How are you going to fit a bridge in this?
How are you going to fit a bridge in this song? And then he does, and then you when you realize that coming out of a bridge is such a great feeling. Coming out of a bridge into a chorus is something they just, a lot of people don't do in music anymore.
It doesn't happen that often, I know. And hearing it in, you know, his first mixtape is kind of cool because it just shows that musical capability, you know, where he's like able to, you know, come up with ideas like that, where it's like, you know what, we could have just done another verse, or could have ended the song here, but fuck it, we're gonna do like a 20-second bridge where I have this breakdown thing. And
I love it.
Track 12, Mad Flavor, Heavy Flow, and we'll let that play into track 13, Kool-Aid and Frozen Pizza.
Oh, it sounds good. That's great, eh? Shimmity dibbity dibbity. Heavy flow.
Hey, Kool-Aid and frozen pizza. It's the work of art, I ain't talking Mona Lisa. We got me laughing like a damn hyena. Yeah, I live a life pretty similar to yours. Used to go to school, hang with friends and play sports. About to be in music stores everywhere, but not yet. They can't understand my concept. I've been climbing up the Great Wall, haven't had
these blogs gotta know I'm on. I love that he says that he's not there yet.
Yeah.
And he understands that. That's fucking great.
Clothes, so I'm wearing them. I smoke herbs and I make music. I don't even talk about it, boy, I just do it. Everybody got the little kid in them, waiting for the game to wanna let him in, so open up. The boy a barrel of a smoking gun. Whether I'm old or young, the chosen one. I got 100 billion flows to come. Yeah, just some motherfucking kids. We just some motherfucking kids. We just some motherfucking kids.
I really can see how this would resonate, like, with that. Yeah, big time. Fuck, I love that pigeon or whatever.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, not a pigeon, but...
Well, yeah, the sound.
Sound, yeah.
Yeah, that's a classic hip-hop...
That's great. You know what? I really like Kool-Aid and Frozen Pizza.
Yeah, it's a chill track, and I like him talking about, like you said, you know, he knows he's not there. He's like, my stuff isn't in the stores because we're not ready for it yet, but I know, you know, he's working his way there. I like him talking about how he's like, you know, I don't talk about making music.
I just do it. I like that. That's exactly, you know, that's what I like about this track, is that he's not super, super over braggadocious at this stage.
Yeah.
Still humble. I'm going to do it. Just wait. I'm going to just shut up and let
it
happen.
He's got that hunger, you know? And
he's got hungry for fucking Kool-Aid
and frozen pizza. But no, I love the hunger that he's got on this mixtape, you know, like he's still trying to prove himself.
Yeah.
But he's also got that confidence because, you know, this is, like I said, it's his first like commercial mixtape, but he's had stuff before. He was rapping for a while. So this is like him experiencing a little bit of success, and then he's drops this project. So it's not like, you know, the very beginning where he's got nothing.
Have you heard some of that?
I haven't gone back and listened to
like the really early, like,
no, I haven't had. I just haven't had the urge to, but it might be interesting to go look at one day, some of his real early stuff.
Blue Slides next, right?
Yeah, that's his commercial debut. Track 14, All I Want Is You.
Girl, I don't wanna share you. We could be together, but you scared to. And when I blow, I hope you know that I could have any girl I choose. But I know as time goes by,
nice vocals.
Baby, all I'm gonna want is you. Girl, I don't wanna share you. They told me never fall in love, it never works out in your favor. You way too young, and right now that's just human nature. Connect like Wi-Fi, mix like tie-dye. She feeling cute, wanna wear a little
reading this writing here, he's got a maturity about him.
Yes,
for like sure. at 17, right?
Yeah. No, I agree.
Player thinks she cute too, but I'ma yank her out the game like a loose tooth. When the boy blow, I know she worried. She can, and you'll be mine.
Yeah, it definitely feels like one of his more mature songs.
Totally, yeah. Wow. Again, I can't imagine me writing this.
Like at his age.
It's not 17.
Yeah.
Again, it's just
the magazine and
yeah.
Going in the next track, but yeah, very mature writing on that one.
Very, very mature, you know. And I like that he's in here. Where was I? I meant to have it here, pinpointed.
One of the lines.
Yeah, one of the lines. But I was just going to say the maturity in the lines. But I like that he starts in this. I love that he starts this track with the chorus.
Yeah,
because it really hooks you, and then he's got the vocal thing going, and then you hear it, and then he just gets into his flow, and his flow is very. It's very serious. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's like. It's a 17-year-old saying that, you know, I just don't want a fucking quick bang bang. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Track 15, Poppy.
Yeah. Hello, death. It seems that we meet again. You keep taking friends that I'll never see again. I guess they gotta leave, but if we pretend that they never left, well, we gon' see them then. I don't think that I'ma make it, because this world is mine for the taking. So when I get famous, they gon' know what your name is, and no one understand what the pain is. And maybe I am a little bit over my head, but I'm feeling so alone, trying to cope with your death. Holding my breath, wishing I had one more day, wishing you could be there when I graduate. And it's sad to say, sleeping at your house, walking me to school.
I love how fucking great the lyrics, yeah. How emotional the lyrics are, but the beat is fucking
great.
Yeah, that's what makes it super powerful, man. If it was slow and sappy,
yeah,
but it's not. It's like
time goes by, going without you. Hope you know I've been thinking about you, and I know that they took you.
Yeah, some great vulnerable lyrics there.
Fucking beautiful. This is great. This is so good. And again, it's too short for me.
3 minutes. That's not
bad. Push it to like 320. I could have used another 20 seconds, just like your mom said. Boom, boom. Great, great lyrics. Like I said, the way that he... If he put it sappy and it was just a keyboard thing, but yeah. The way it was,
if he did it slow or something,
yeah, it would. For me, it was because it was driving, and yeah. Then he's really, you can feel it coming out of here.
Yeah,
you know
it's
what I mean?
Right from the heart.
It's right from the heart. That was beautiful. It almost had me crying, but I thought, you know what? I'm not going to cry on this because it reminded me of my grandfather, and then it reminded me of like, well, you weren't very close. Super close to my dad, right?
Who, no, because he was, or I was very young.
Very, you were young when he passed, right?
Yeah.
But no, just seeing it and all, you know, just the way that he talked. You know what? We started this album at 17.
Mm-hmm.
He's 38.
He feels older.
I bet you this album just like his soul, 38. Yeah. Like,
he just keeps getting older. Track 16, Face in the Crowd.
Nice. Yeah.
We gon' start this one like this. Driving down the road with a couple more miles to go. I'm so close, but they don't know. Got some freaky hoes and weed to blow. Don't you feel good? Don't you feel great? I feel so fly and I hope you can relate. Got some brand new shoes and a brand new tee. It's the same old dude with a brand new me. Be stupid if I try, but I'm using a maneuver. Keep on moving them aside. I'm just trying to make some music for the ride. Listen to it when you drive, destination you arrive. Russell Crowe, just a beautiful mind. Got talent, imagine what I'll do with some time. Losing a brand new tee.
That's a good feeling.
Yeah,
nice shoes, new t-shirt, yeah.
Thought I was the coolest motherfucker around.
Yeah, the humbleness is there.
I love that. That's what's so beautiful.
Yeah, It's a great listen, and I think, you know, now that we're done the project here, I think you can see why this was so impactful for my friends and I.
Oh, at a young
age, like having this as our
this
between this and Man on the Moon 1.
Yeah,
like we were fucking set, man. We just put these two back to back, and we were just listening all the time. That's like all we listen to.
Yeah, you know, fuck. I smile because I'm smiling because you are really giving me a taste of your youth, and in turn, it's making me at my age right now feel younger.
Yes.
Which is like fucking really cool. That is
pretty cool.
No, it is, because I feel, just listening to that now, I feel I'm going to jump on that fucking BMX and I'm going to go for that red hot burrito at 7-Eleven. Yeah,
maybe not. Maybe skip the burrito. Maybe just the bike ride.
I might not make it back.
Yeah. Anyway, we'll end the video off here. I had a good time. I hope you had a good time.
I had a fucking great, anytime Mac's involved.
It's a great time.
It's a great time for me.
And I hope you guys had a good time. Full episode uncut on Patreon if you want to check it out, and we'll see you soon with some more album or mixtape reactions, because we've been doing mixtapes a little bit lately, but we'll see you with either. So take care, guys.
Bye bye.
Peace.